Hello students, welcome to today video classroom. Subject computer science, paper programming in Java, second unit, second chapter, exceptions. Today topic exception. So today class we'll discuss what is exception, what are the different types of exceptions. So what is exception? Exception means an action. Exception is a condition. Exception is an action or condition. So that condition will occur due to the unexpected behavior in a normal execution of the program. That means whenever we are running a program, while executing the statements in the program, there may be some unexpected behavior. So there is unexpected problems. So those problems will stop the execution of the program. So that unexpected behavior, that unexpected condition is called as an event, exception. Simply, exceptions are the actions that may cause a runtime error. Exceptions are the conditions that may cause a runtime error. The program lo execute avutundi ante run avetappudu program running middle lone stop ayipothundi enduku oka error jaragadam valla ante program lo errors running lo errors ostayi ante compilation lo errors undochu program running lo errors undochu compilation errors anedi initial gane check chestundi compiler check chestundi so running exceptions anedi running time lo program run ayye time lo some errors ane jarugutuntai so alante errors jariginappudu program middle lo aagipothundi so aa errors enduku jarugutayi edaina oka condition meet kaanappudu condition satisfy cheyaleni situation lo unte appudu errors jarugutayi so that condition is called as an exception. Simple, exception is an event that arises due to the occurrence of unexpected behavior in a certain situation. Exception is a condition that may stop the execution of the program. Exception is a condition that may raise the runtime error and stop the execution of the program. Exception is a condition that may raise a runtime error and stop the program execution. So ade program execution stop oka raise oka error generate chesi program execution stop chesetunnadi condition edaitundo that condition is called as an exceptional cases, exception. So those are maybe rarely occurred, that's why they are called as exception. Those may be rarely occurred. If that condition does not satisfy, automatically the program will be executed as usual, normally execute avutundi. But when that condition will occur, then only that program will stop. What type of conditions? So for example, I am performing a calculation, C is equal to A by B. So it will ask the user to enter the input data, A is equal to and B is equal to. The user enter the A is equal to 5, B is equal to 2, and will print the C value system.out.5/2. That is, it will print the 2.5 or 2. If C is a double dot, it will print the 2.5. If C is an integer, it will print the 2. That's it. There is no problem. But if the denominator B value is 0, 5 by 0 means it cannot determine. So automatically it cannot print the C value. It cannot print the C value. So automatically the execution will be stopped. So the type of situation is called as an exception. What is exception here? The denominator is 0. That is exception. We are dividing a number by 0, that is an exception, that is a rare condition, that is a condition. When the remainder denominator is 0, it cannot divide the number with 0. A number would 0 to divide cheyalemu, appudu program execution ni stop aipothundi. Denominator 0 kavadanni, denominator 0 ayyatundi situation ayyindo, denominator value 0 ichetundi action ayyindo, that action is called as an exception. Here the exception is dividing a number is 0. So that is exception. So for example, a declared an array with size integer a of 5. So what is the size of the array? 5. That means the values will be stored from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because the index starts from 0, the element's index also ends with the 4 only. But when accessing, I want to access a of 6. Which element will be displayed? For example, if you write the a of 2, the value at the index 2 will be displayed. But I am trying to access the value at the a of 6. 6th location lo an element display chestunnam. But index 1 ekkada undayindi? 4th undayindi. But we are trying to index. Automatically, which value has to be displayed? So the index value is 2, there is no problem. The index value comes out of its range, there is a problem. That means we are trying to access an item that is not there. Okay, so this is called when the index goes to out of its boundary, array index goes to out of its boundary. Actually, array index boundary in the size and size 5 unte, boundary is 0 to 4 only. But we are going to out of its boundary. So that is an exception situation. That is a condition when that a runtime error will be occurred. So those type of conditions are called as a exceptions. So these are called as a exception. Simple. Exception is a condition that may raise a runtime error and stop the program execution, normal execution of the program. Exception is a condition that raise runtime error and stops program execution. So this is an exception. The examples for the exceptions can arise due to the number of situations as given below, dividing by a 0, the denominator 0 unnapudu. Trying to access 6th element of an array when array contains only 5 values, accessing a file which is not present. So manamu C++ lo file io concept chusam, even Java lo kuda file io concept untundi. Oka file lo unna number ni reach chestunnanu, automatically computer. Next, for example, so in previous classes wrapper classes is there. Wrapper class lo there is a parseInt method is there. What is the parseInt method? The parseInt method will convert a string format and number into integer. String format, actually 32 is numeric value, but it is in the double quotation lo untundi, string value avutundi. A string value ni integer lo conversion chesinappudu automatically idi integer lo vachestundi. But by using parseInt method, we can convert a string format and number to numeric number. For example, I have used this parseInt method to convert to a string, for example, ABC into integer. This parseInt method ni ABC anedi an integer lo conversion chesam. Idi kuda oka string kada, idi string, idi string. Ee rendu strings ni ante parseInt method em chestundi, string parameter teeskuntundi. If a string parameter numeric values unde integer lo convert chestundi, alphabets unde mari integer lo ela convert chestundi sir? Automatically invalid number format exception anedi generate avutundi. Ante number convert chesinatvanti, this is not a numeric number, so you cannot convert it. So like that, so some errors may be generated. So there are the two types of exceptions. Exceptions are classified into two types. Those are the checked exceptions, unchecked exceptions. So generally, some exceptions are checked by the compiler itself. Java compiler matrame compiler check chestundi, those are called as a checked exception. Checked exceptions are exception for which the compiler checks to see whether they have been handled in our program or not. Mana program lo handles alante errors handle chesamo ledha anedi check chestundi. Those are called as a checked exception. Ante compiler recognize chesetatvanti exceptions evithunyo, those are called as a checked exceptions. When the checked exceptions are there in our program, compiler automatically recognize those checked exception and reports that error before while compiling the program. And program ni compile chesetappudu ikkada error undi ani cheppesi ilanti ikkada runtime error jaragochu ane oka error report chestundi. Adhe unchecked exception means these are not checked by the compiler. And agar program compile chesetappudu ee unchecked errors ni identify cheyadu. Program run avutunnayi, 2, 3, 4 statements execute avutayi, then eppudaithe runtime error occur avutundo automatically program execution avutundi. Those are called as unchecked exceptions. Simple. The exceptions that will be checked by the compiler. The exceptions that will be checked by the compiler are called as the checked exceptions. Unchecked exception that are not checked by the compiler is called as a unchecked exception. So to whenever the compiler cannot catch an exception, whenever the compiler cannot check the exception, we need to write a program. We need to write a program to handle these exceptions, to see whether those exceptions are occurred. But our exception jarinappudu brain cheyali program middle lo stop kaakunda some error message display chesi mana program continuous anedi ellali. So alanti situations kosam mana em cheyali appudu exceptions ni handle cheyali. So mana exceptions handle cheyadaniki java.lang package provides several predefined packages, several predefined packages. So these all the predefined packages are the subclasses of a class called as exception class. First java.lang package lo exception ane class undi, aa exception class ko subclasses unnai, several classes unnai. So predefined exception classes em undani ippudu chuddam. So chaala unnai, common ga undetatundi ivadam jarigindi ikkada arithmetic exception. So this arithmetic exception will be occurred when the denominator is zero, that is dividing a number by zero. Dividing a number by zero, denominator zero unnappudu arithmetic exception oka exception generate avutundi, handle exception catch chesi manamu message display chesi program middle lo stop kaakunda proper ga message display cheyali. So for example, such simple next io exception divilla eppudaithe file not found, endu manu cheppanu oka file lo unna data ni read chestundi. So for example, you are reading a data from a file, but that is the input operation, but the file is not available in that location. At that time, some input output operation exception will be occurred, that is the IO exception. Next, array store exception. Array store exception means that there is an integer array is there, but we are trying to store a float value into the array, integer array, that is a incompatible array type, where array data type is integer, but we are trying to store float data type, that is another data type. So that type of exception is called as a array store exception. Next is a array index out of bounds exception. So previously we discussed that if the array index boundary is up to 0 to 4 only, but we are trying to access a sixth element, so this is called as a array index out of bounds exception. Array index out of bounds exception. Next one is a number format exception. Number format exception. Number format exception means I already told previously. So for example, if your parseInt method is there to convert a string format and number into integer format member. ParseInt method will convert a string format number into integer format number. But instead of writing string number, string format number, we have passed a alphabets A, B, C. Can you convert A, B, C to integers? No. So at that time, number format exception will be occurred. So these are the some basic exceptions. These are the commonly raised exceptions. So simple program rasna ganu, simple basic programs rasna gani, these exceptions are never raised out to untai. Okay, so this is exceptions. Next, why we have to handle these exceptions in our program? Why we have to see that whether these exceptions are properly handled or not? So for example, see, when you are manamu ATM center kellam, amount draw cheskodan kellam, account lo 3000 rupees balance undi, manamu we are trying to withdraw 5000 rupees. అక్కడ మనకి ఏం జరగాలి, నీ అకౌంట్లో 3000 అంటే ఇన్సఫిషియంట్ బ్యాలెన్స్ అని ప్రాపర్గా మెసేజ్ డిస్ప్లే చేసి ఆ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ క్లోజ్ కావాలా, లేకపోతే ప్రోగ్రామ్ అక్కడితో మిడిల్గా ఆగిపోయి సిస్టమ్ స్ట్రక్ అయిపోవాలా? వి హ్యావ్ టు, వెన్ విత్డ్రాల్ అమౌంట్ ఈస్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ బ్యాలెన్స్ అమౌంట్, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు డిస్ప్లే ద ప్రాపర్ మెసేజ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్సఫిషియంట్ బ్యాలెన్స్, దెర్ ఇస్ ఎన్ ఇన్సఫిషియంట్ బ్యాలెన్స్ అని ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఆగిపోవాలి. వి హావ్ దెర్ when the balance withdrawal amount is greater than the balance amount, that a runtime exception will be generated. That runtime exception has to be handled properly, and you have that handling technique will display a proper message that the balance, there is an insufficient fund, and we you have to close all the input and output streams and you have to stop the program execution. That means you have to close the transaction, complete the transaction. So manaki DBMS concept lo chusam, transaction complete kaakapothe middle lo undi ankonde automatically untai, all the resources will be locked by the transaction, will be wait continuously. అంటే ఒక ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ కంప్లీట్ చేయకపోతే కంప్లీట్ అయ్యేంత వరకు కూడా అదర్ ఆర్ రిసోర్సెస్ మీద ఉన్న లాక్ అలానే ఉండిపోతుంది. అందుకని ఆ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ కంప్లీట్ కావాలి. కంప్లీట్ కావాలంటే ప్రోగ్రామ్ అనేది కంటిన్యూస్గా ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ కావాలి, మిడిల్లో స్టాప్ కావద్దు. సో టు దట్ వన్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు హ్యాండిల్ ద ఎక్సెప్షన్స్ ప్రాపర్లీ. సో దీస్ ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్ మెకానిజం విల్ బి సీన్ ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్, ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వీడియో. దట్ ఈస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్ ఎవ్రీ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ టర్మినాలజీ. ఇఫ్ యూ గో ఇఫ్ యూ ఇన్ ద సి ప్లస్ ప్లస్ యూ ఆర్ స్టడీ ద ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్, ఇన్ పిఎల్ఎస్క్యూఎల్ యూ ఆర్ స్టడీ ద ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్, వెన్ యూర్ జావా యూ ఆర్ స్టడీంగ్ ద ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్, ఇఫ్ యూ గో ఫర్ వెబ్ టెక్నాలజీ దేర్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్ మెకానిజం ఇస్ దేర్. సో దెర్ ఇస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్ట్ బికాస్ ఇన్ ఎవ్రీ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ లాంగ్వేజ్ వెన్ యూఆర్ రైటింగ్ ఏ ప్రోగ్రామ్ దేర్ మే బీ ఎ సిచ్యువేషన్ దట్ సమ్ టైమ్ ఎర్రర్స్ మే బీ అకర్డ్ డ్యూ టు ద యూజర్ డేటా. యూజర్ ఎంటర్ చేసినటువంటి డేటా వల్ల ప్రోగ్రామ్లో ఎర్రర్ జరుగుతుంది. నీ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్లో ఎలాంటి తప్పు లేదు, ప్రోగ్రామింగ్లో ఎలాంటి రాంగ్ లేదు, బట్ యూజర్ ఇచ్చినటువంటి డేటా ఇన్వాలిడ్ డేటా కావచ్చు. సో ఎంటర్ టూ నెంబర్స్ ఉంటే డినామినేటర్ వాల్యూ యూజర్ జీరో ఇచ్చినప్పుడు వీ హ్యావ్ టు హ్యాండిల్ దట్ డేటా ప్రాపర్లీ. అలాంటి డేటాని ఇచ్చిన డేటాని హ్యాండ్ వ్యాలిడ్ ఇన్వాలిడ్ చెక్ చేసి ప్రాపర్ మెసేజ్ డిస్ప్లే చేయాలి. సో ఫర్ దట్ రీజన్ వీ నీడ్ టు స్టడీ ఎక్సెప్షన్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్. We have to handle that exception. So in the next class, we will see about the exception handling techniques. Okay, students.